My name is Patrice Nyembo. I am the president of Congolese Community of Australia. I'm also Social Welfare Secretary of the African Community Council, born in the refugee camps. And why I say that? Because I have experienced a lot of atrocities since my young age. I know UN, I know US, America, I know Belgium, I know Europe. And after some time, I've been also pushed to come here in Australia, where I did get my first citizenship with, I am enjoying it now. The history of Congo, it's the same, it's just one. First, the beginning, Africa was enjoying its freedom. But when the first invaders came into Africa, they found flora, fauna, and resources. They were amazed and they fell in love with Africa, and they were thinking to go in Africa to settle there. With our hospitality, our hand it was opened till Leopold II heard about what it was going at that time in Africa. He decided to go just in the heart of Africa to occupy the Congo. And from there, he start his empire and his business. During that business, he killed 50% of the population in Congo at that time. And the remaining one-third part were amputated. And at that time, Edmond Morel was a journalist. He went to Congo, he looked at it, it was a new man. He went to Europe, USA, to talk about it, until they decide to call for the Berlin Conference. It was in 1884. They started that meeting, which never ends. It was the longest meetings Europe, USA, never. That meeting to devise Africa went for 1 year. And during that time, all people who was advocated for human rights, they've been killed. They've been dismissed in that meeting. It's not only they killed Congolese. No, those multinationals started since long time their greediness. They killed even some of British people, Belgian people, who were advocates for human rights. And after that, they said no, Congo have to be looking by the Belgium. And Belgium, it was like a caretaker about 7 countries of Europe plus the USA was looking at the Belgium, how it was taking the resources and the use to devise those resources. Congo never, even until now, spend or take resources and sell. Even during the independence, it was the Belgium who was selling for Congo. Okay, after that, the time of independence came. The time of independence, no. We didn't ask, the leaders at that time was not asking for the independence. When the people was trying to free themselves, the Belgium say, okay, we'll give you independence. But the leaders at that time, they was looking for the colonization. And that the colonization didn't happen, they give them independence. And during that independence, the first man who was fought for the freedom, it was Patrice Emery Lumumba. After 6 months, they killed him. They replaced him with Mobutu. What I want to say, I want to summarize, like, the multinational started with Leopold II in Africa with the cooperation of other multinationals. Even now, they just change the colors, they just change the leaders, they just change the stories, but the action, the strategies, it's still the same. Now, we have 9.5 million died, been killed. Why? Because of the resources. Behind that, there is the support of USA, Commonwealth, and all the Eastern power countries. Most of them, they've been dictated also by the multinational companies. That's why today we came to the roots. We have to call us all of the grassroots. No difference of color, no difference of language, no difference of tribe, to fight for those multinational companies to stop that. Otherwise, if we leave them, they will go and suck our blood. Now they are in Australia, in America, all over the world. They don't care, even the governments. Those governments, they are like puppets. They are just following what the big corporations are leading them to say and to do. That's why I call for all Australians, for all citizens of the world, to stand up, to say no. All the 99% of the citizens of the world, they have to stand up and to stop them. Otherwise, we'll lose this planet. For example, in Congo, those multinationals, they are cutting trees. And we have that global warming. We have all of those climate change. If really we can leave Congo with those trees, it can help a lot to this environment. But because of the greedy of that few people, this world become hell. I'm calling for the people of the world to stand up, the citizen of the world. I am Australian who have lived here and studied here. Despite my French accent, I know now and I can see like an eagle. I've been in Congo, I've been in Australia, and I say for the people of Australia to stand up and to face. Otherwise, in 2-3 years, it will be worse than this. Kevin Rudd is talking. He's talking about what is going in Tripoli, what is going in Libya, but he didn't talk about what is going now in Congo. I would like to inform you, even they appoint an ambassador 2 months ago in Congo. It didn't last there for long. He just leave the office and went back to Zimbabwe. He found like in Zimbabwe, it's peacefully, it's safer more than Congo. This is amazing. Thank you.